Sorry. We felt it better if your visit to this country wasn't recorded by immigration. Took a bit of doing. I assume you're clean.
I am. I'm also cold and tired, so could we move rather rapidly along? Colonel Faulkner, I'm Thomas Balfour.
Howdy.
Do come and meet Sir Edward Matheson.
Matheson is in merchant banking.
That's correct.
Faulkner?
What do I call you? Sir Edward.
You do.
You drink whiskey, I believe. Sir or water?
Large and straight, thank you.
It's good of you to come at such short notice.
Depends upon your definition of good. First-class air ticket and an unsigned cheque for £2,000 are pretty fair persuaders. I assume that's my time, my trouble, and a rather rushed meal on the plane. Would you be good enough to sign it now? Thank you. Another.
Please, feel free with my whiskey.
I will. Thank you. I'm dry when I work.
Yes, so I've heard.
There's a special clause in my contract which says that my liver is to be buried separately with honours.
I'm not a very humorous man.
So I noticed.
Now, explain to me what happened to your contract with Julius Limbani.
You know very well what happened. You didn't pick my name out of a hat.
It was a disastrous failure.
It wasn't my failure. You didn't arrive.
Mr. Limbani, I'm sorry to interrupt your nap. I'm going to divert the plane. An old friend of yours is waiting to see you. Just sit quietly.
Now, look, that was 2 years ago. I got your autograph, Sir Edward. Why?
Copper.
Now, let's see if I can put all the pieces together. Just for the exercise. General Indover, one of the most corrupt dictators in Africa, deposes Limbani as head of state.
Now, do you mind if I cut through all this? Uganda agreed to hold Limbani for him and then refused to give him back. They announced that he died of a heart attack and then threatened Ndofa they'd set him free.
The dogs.
Ndofa can't stand the possibility of Limbani reincarnated taking over his country again. So he's offered some of our copper concessions in return for the secret delivery of Limbani into his hands.
And you want me to intercept him and deliver him to you?
Correct.
Where do I find him?
He's been moved across the border and taken to an army barracks at Zimbabwe. Now Ndofa will leave Kurundi on the same day and personally execute Limbani and scatter his ashes. Any questions?
For the moment, just two. First, how soon can you confirm the exact date of Limbani's arrival in Zimbabwe?
7 days before. That's guaranteed.
Good. Two, can you hold General Ndofa in Kurundi while I'm grabbing Limbani?
That can be arranged.
Excellent. That's all for now.
Don't you wish to discuss your fees and expenses?
Well, first of all, I have to find out if the project is feasible. If it is, I send you an account. I don't discuss fees. I get what I want.
I realize you get paid for risking your life. I do hope you don't consider it too valuable. Goodbye, Faulkner. We shan't be seeing each other again. A great pleasure for both of us, I'm sure.
Here we are.
Here. This is it?
Here's your too well-known to stand a first-class hotel. Now, in here's a passport, driving license, all the usual papers, and a phone number where I can always be reached. You are to deal directly with me. It's my job to provide you with everything you need.
All right, Thomas, you're going to work immediately. I want a detailed map of the area around Zimbabwe, plus a scale model of the barracks, plus all the details you can get me on the garrison strength.
It'll be delivered by hand.
Good. Now, I want you to find me two men. First, Rayford Jarndyce. If he's alive, he's here somewhere in London.
Rayford Jarndyce? Fair hair, cigarette holder, wears glasses.
It's the man. Now, this is going to be a tough assignment. No Rayford Jarndyce, no contract.
I'll phone you about him in an hour. And the other one?
Sean Finn. Very good looking.
I know the name Sean Finn. I'll do my best, but he's a problem.
You better find him. Same goes to him. No Sean, no deal.
Thank you. Randy, you don't come in here.
He's got problems, Mr. Martin. I'm sorry as hell.
Go on. I'll be out in a minute. Close the door. So,
go ahead.
What is it?
You should have told me I was carrying heroin. I said no drugs.
What did you think the delivery list was for, Hershey bars?
I thought it was cash. I didn't push drugs ever. It's my religion.
You're telling me what you do or don't do for me?
More or less.
Randy, break any two items you like on this man and throw them out. If I ever see your face again, you're dead.
Now get your hands on your head.
You move over with it! On your head!
You want to take it easy. He's just a snub-nosed kid. His old man has something very special back in the States.
You finished? Yes, sonny.
Open it!
I pulled all the envelopes into one bag, just for convenience. Now here I am, just starting to work for you, two beauties. I make my first contact. It was a young girl. She was alone on a bed, dying. That's when I opened the package. You boys are pushing bad stuff. So what I'd like you to do is each eat half of it.
You're crazy.
She was barely 19. Now on your knees and eat.
You too. Oh, God, please.
You have a big appetite, Sonny. Because it's all yours.
Please.
No words exactly. Now eat.
Now do it. Do it! All of it!
Pour it down. I used rain for a stomach pump that had strychnine in it. Still, they say a little suffering is good for the soul. It may last 20 minutes.
The best meals I've ever cooked.
Corned lobster.
Well, I had to unwrap it, didn't I?
You promised you'd tell me right after dinner.
Well, I haven't had my coffee yet.
You don't even drink coffee.
Ah, true. Are you ready? Sure? Okay. Now, when do you get home from school for your Christmas holidays?
December the 12th. You know that.
But when do you go back?
January the 9th. Come on, Dad.
Now, isn't that a fantastic coincidence? You know, this is the bad little wine we have here.
Why? Oh, Dad, please.
All right. Now, this is how it goes. On December the 13th, you and I and a couple of suitcases are jumping on board an airplane.
Where are we going?
Wait a second. That same plane will bring us back on January the 3rd.
Skiing!
You've got it!
Switzerland!
The very thing!
Oh, boy, that is fantastic!
Yes, it is.
Just the two of us.
Well, who else? Are we going to stay in a beautiful little inn?
I'm so excited, I don't know what to do.
Well, why don't you try screaming? The neighbors are deaf anyway.
Yahoo!
Screaming about.
Well, that was Emil expressing mild satisfaction. Emil, come here. I want to meet Mrs. Ball. Alan, my son, Emil.
Hello, hi.
Pleased to meet you, sir.
The sir is a byproduct of expensive English education.
What a pity they don't export it.
Excuse me, sir. Hope to see you later, sir.
So do I. What is meant, child?
I'll tell you about it later.
Pour me a drink. Let's sit down and have a talk. It's been 9 years.
10, actually. Where have they all gone? Well, to hell with it. We'll drink to something, right? Let's drink to the years before the 10.
To the next 10 weeks.
What does that mean?
To you, Raver, old friend.
Okay. To me.
Ah, disgusting.
Yes, isn't it? What do you mean, to the next 10 weeks?
Come on, Raver, just let's talk.
Oh, no, Alan. I'm not available. I'm trying to go old gracefully. I'm searching to see if I can find my God. trying to learn how to appreciate life and practice the art of inner peace. Now, you believe all that's crap shit.
I do.
You're right. All except the I'm not available about it. I know.
All right, I got that from the top.
Well, now, tell me, how did you find me?
I asked. Incidentally, how's that 19-year-old French beauty?
Oh, that 19-year-old French beauty is now 29 and living in Paris.
She left you?
Yes. She's Emile's mother. She sees him once or twice a year. I haven't seen her since he was two. He goes to boarding school in Kent. I mean, what would I do with him full time? I love him. He's a wonderful boy. Weekends and holidays are the greatest moments of my life. I'm taking him skiing for Christmas. 3 weeks, leaving December 13th.
December 13th.
God, I can't wait. Here's the love of me. Tell me, how's Jenny?
She died 3 years ago.
What?
Some kind of bone cancer. Took a month, that's all.
I'm sorry.
So am I, fine woman.
Yeah, she was a great woman. Look, I'll
accept it.
Okay. Done is done. Come on, tell me. About the kids, how are the kids?
Oh, all right. They're grown up. Don't see them much anymore. I think they're not too happy about me. These are beautiful.
Yes, they are, aren't they? I buy them, sell them. I'm getting pretty good at it. I earn about 15,000 a year.
Julius Limbani is alive.
I don't care.
Yes, you do. If there's one African leader you do care about, it's Julius Limbani.
Now, I'm telling you, Alan, I'm finished with all of that. I'm getting too old, by the way, so are you.
You know, apart from your sparkling personality and the fact that you're the finest planner I've ever known, what I've always admired about you, Rafer, is your idealism.
Bollocks.
The money wasn't important to you. It was the bad guys against the good guys. And you would never work for the bad guys. Now, me, I work for anybody, as long as they pay me. It's an ineradicable flaw in my character. So that's why you always impress me, Rafer. Always.
Well, I'm glad to hear you say that. Do you know how many times I've been wrong? Out there somewhere singing hallelujah, fighting and killing for some goddamn savior who, as soon as he got to power, began to steal his own treasury. But I don't know who the good guys are anymore.
You know Limbani. You know he's the best there is. Now, I have a contract to steal Limbani from General Andover. If I don't, he dies. If I do, well, perhaps he's running his country again. I need you to plan it.
The answer's too long.
Now, I'm going to start training in Africa until January the 15th, so I can spare you your holiday with your child. It's a very big paycheck, tax-free.
Alan, it's really been great seeing you again. But don't spoil it.
All right. Will you do me a favor?
Eh?
Show me. Clear that stuff away. Show me how I get in and out of this place. Barney will be here, somewhere in that cell.
Hello.
I got Rafer Jarvis.
Good. You haven't got Sean Finn.
What do you mean?
He's either dead by now, or he will be the second he shows his face anywhere in London.
Right, what happened?
Boiled down, he removed two of the family's men earlier this evening, one of whom happened to be the nephew of the local godfather. They've already got out a contract on Finn's, the biggest London's ever seen.
Get it?
That is impossible.
Come on, who's got the biggest chance? Edward Matheson and all those banks, or the local mafia?
Well, that's not even a question.
You want me, Barney? Get that contract, you.
Oh, what's so special about him? Look, this afternoon he was working as a courier for a 25-year-old hoodlum.
If you've ever seen him operating in the field, you know what's so special about him. Also, he can fly any plane you care to name, and he's my friend. I don't have too many left. He's number three in this deal, or there is no deal. What a moral crisis that would present to kindly Sir Edward. He'd have to have Rafer and me killed, wouldn't he? So you get the details of Shaw's past year over to my unspeakable hotel as soon as you can. Rafer and I are going after him.
Now, wait a minute. That's not your territory. You stay out. Not even supposed to be in this country, remember?
Ask your friend for a doggy bag after you pay the bill. I'll be waiting for you in my room. Number 23A, there it is.
Keep driving, keep driving.
How many is that?
Five.
With a welcoming committee at each one, boy, what efficiency. How many have we left?
Four.
Oh, sure. Living with nine women in the 1 year, possibly at the same time.
Quite a feat, but not beyond it. I have a court name. The Baronet Club, Denby Road. No home address, probably sits on the crap table. Well, we can but try.
Hey, you buy the chips there, Charlie.
Very well. It's 200. Thank you very much.
Well, I'm going to get me some chips, and I'm going to break the house. Tell her.
Flight 20. Heather Hunt is at the first flight deck table over there.
Oh, so she is. Now, how come you wear her chest?
What you say?
I don't know. How come you wear Heather's chest?
Hey there, Robert. How's it doing there? Is this table hot? Yeah. How are you? Now, you just tell me how much is that there, gentlemen.
What's the minute?
20.
Well, then you give it to us, Heather Hunt.
If you don't believe, you'll have to leave.
Ooh. How do you know my name?
How do I know your name, Heather, honey? Well, don't stop. Keep dealing. Listen very carefully. We need your help. We need it very badly. Where's Sean Finn?
Who? I don't know any Sean Finn.
Yes, you do.
Hey, look at that. I got a genuine blackjack. See that genuine blackjack, Bella? I'm out of the box.
He's in great trouble. If you know what he is, tell us. The mafia has a contract out on him, and if they get to him before we do, they'll kill him.
We're talking about a matter of minutes. The army's close, friends.
Check with him on the phone and tell him it's Rafer Jarndyce and Alan Faulkner. Describe us, so you be sure and do it now, without us, he's a dead man.
Okay, I believe you. He's right here in this building. Behind the men's loo, there's a stairway. Top floor, first room on the left.
Sean, it's Alan.
Alan? Well, not even a hearty handshake. Sean, my boy, how are you? Nothing?
Clown.
Oh, clown. Well, at least that's a start. Now, would you mind telling me what you're doing here, thank God?
If we live, I'll tell you about it. Idiot.
Clown and idiot. You always were a flatterer.
Never change, do you, Sean? There's a whole army looking for you, and you're still making jokes. Now, let's get out of here.
Oh, no, you're making jokes. Where to?
Bye-bye. Open up. Car just pulled up to the back door.
Ah. Rafer. What are you doing?
Recycling a bicycle. Maniac.
Oh, is that smashing? Everybody's calling me names. There's another car in front. I think we'd better do a little praying. Somebody's trying to lift this contract. What contract? Who? Would somebody mind telling me what's going on? Rafer, what are you carrying?
Carrying this and this. Sort of balances me up.
Mr. Martin, I do appreciate your coming at such short notice.
At 4 o'clock in the morning, I would imagine you would. I want to get home to bed and go to sleep. What do you want?
I want you to lift the contract on Sean Finn.
He killed my brother's son.
From what I've learned, your brother's better off without that son.
You tell him that. He's grieving.
He'll get over it. Now, let's get down to facts. Now, I control a number of newspapers. I guarantee you, the day after Sean Finn's death, you and your family will be among the most written about and photographed men in England.
The wrong room. We should have waited 3 minutes.
All right, let's get out of here. The last thing we need is the police.
Wait a minute.
Very gentle circles you move in.
Oh, Heather, I'm sorry. Sean. Yes, I know. She doesn't want to turn the wrong room. You get her to a doctor. Heather, there's a slight urge, you say. You know nothing right. I'll make it up to you, I swear.
You ran along, love. It was a pleasure having you served. If I still have my teeth.
Thanks. Well, thank you, your clods.
Thank you. You're a good girl.
Well, kiss her and come on.
Isn't he in love?
I don't want to appear rude, Thomas, but exactly who the devil is he?
Let's just say he's a military advisor.
Where's he from?
A government department who has as much interest in Lombardy as we have.
Which government?
And that is all you get to know. Now, he's going to say yay or nay to your plan, and his decision is final, so why don't you just start your briefing?
There's no need to be hostile, Colonel Faulkner. We'd very much like this to succeed.
So would we. Rafer?
All right, from the top. We'll use 50 men. 4 officers, 4 NCOs, 40 enlisted men, 1 medic and 1 sergeant major who will be in charge of training and discipline.
Who's the 4th officer? Mr. Finn has somebody in mind. Peter something. Curtsy.
He's a South African. Served there with security police on the border for years and knows the bush better than anyone.
You'll be good, I can guarantee it. And we'll interview him when you approve the plan.
We'll recruit in London, group, and train in Swaziland. I assume you can arrange that. We'll fly from Swaziland here. We'll be dropped from a Hercules cargo plane, which is on a scheduled flight to Rwanda.
You'll be parachuting in.
No, actually, they're going to free fall before dawn from 25,000 feet. The parachute...
You'll be using oxygen. Would you allow him to pause?
Thank you, Alan. Oxygen, no. The cabin will be pressurized. We'll depressurize 3 minutes before the fall.
Mm-hmm.
The parachutes open at 1,500 feet. They won't hear the plane or see us land. The plane will continue, refuel, come back, pick us up. We'll be on the ground for exactly 3 hours. I pause.
You're doing beautifully. Continue.
There's a plateau here, 7 miles from Zimbabwe in the hills. We drop and split into two groups. First group, which will be Alan's, will take the army barracks, which is 4 miles from the drop zone here. The second group, which is Sean, will take the airport here, which is 3 miles from the barracks. The first group will proceed and take Limbani out, go to the airport. With proper timing, the plane should land 10 to 15 minutes later and pick us all up. I have pause again.
What's your plan for the barracks?
Well, these barracks were constructed to hold 200 men, if my information is correct.
It is, I committed it. 25 of you are going to take Limbani away from 200 men.
Huh? Well, they'll be asleep. We'll dispose of the guards here, here, and here. Cut the wires, enter here, proceed to the barracks here, here, and here with their gas masks and cyanide gas canisters. And they really won't know what hit them.
My God, you mean to say that you intend to kill them all? Anything of a better way?
The UN will go mad. Not if we get Limbani out. General Ndofa won't say a word, otherwise he's got too much explaining to do to his own people. You see, he told them that Limbani was dead, remember? And our objective is to get Limbani out.
Quite right. Your plan's approved, gentlemen. Well done, Raven.
Thank you.
Oh, there's one small change. We received some updated information this morning. The operation has been moved forward 3 weeks. I assume you can handle that.
Yes.
Excellent. Good day, gentlemen.
His back running straight as his spine and snap.
Here's the signed contracts.
Read them.
Yes. Open-ended checking account on a Swiss bank. All expenses for weapons, equipment, etc. to be itemized. That's all right. Yes. 1/3 of all wages to be paid in advance. All right, fair enough. £100,000 for you. £50,000 for janitors. £30,000 for each of the other officers. £20,000 for each of the NCOs and the RSM. £10,000 for each of the enlisted men. And 1/2 of these amounts, if the mission fails, that's absolutely outrageous.
I sent him exactly. You sign here.
Yeah?
Good. Here's your contract. You can go outside and scream in the corridor. Sean, would you be good enough to show Mr. Bell the part?
Yes, of course.
Rafer, I had no idea.
I know.
There'll be other holidays.
Alan, I'd like your approval on some weapons and supplies here.
Excuse me, but you wouldn't happen to know a Sandy Young around here, would you?
Colonel Faulkner.
How are you, Sandy?
Couldn't be better, sir. Yourself?
Not bad.
I can't tell you what a pleasure it is to see you, sir. Brings back memories I never thought I'd hit. Not in the afternoon, not in the inside.
Your wife now?
Yes, sir, she is. She'll be delighted.
I don't think so. I think we'd better talk out here. Tell me, how's your retirement going?
As is point, sir?
Such as?
Fucking rose bushes, upon my French, sir, and whipping into shape nicely, and that's about it.
How would you like to whip 50 men to shape for me?
Are you serious, sir?
That's why I'm here. I need a sergeant major. You're the best I've ever known.
Not too old?
What do you think?
Sir, where do I report? When?
Sandy, it's tea.
Look who's here, love.
Good afternoon.
Yes, I see. I hope I'd never see him again.
That's no way to beat an old friend, Marjorie.
He's not my friend. He's on the table. You're not welcome, Mr. Faulkner.
My apologies, sir.
I understand. There'll be some ground now, won't there?
Yes, a good deal of it, but she'll get over it. She's a lovely girl.
Yes, she is. Well, send you go in and call me at this number tonight.
Sir.
Right, sir. Excuse me. Thank you, the
other half. Sean.
Sean Finn. How are you, Peter?
That's a good question if you have a few hours. What are you doing down here?
Looking for you.
Yes, sir.
Oh, two of these, please.
How did you find me?
Your landlady. By the way, she asked me to tell you that if you don't pay the rent, you can pack and get out by the morning.
Rent? That's chuckled. I haven't even got the money to buy you one back. Why would you be looking for me?
Well, I have a job.
Thanks, I've been in jail once. I didn't like it.
You'll
change that. That's marvelous, isn't it? Thank you. I now have to prove to you that crime is only a hobby with me. It's not that kind of job.
No?
Look, all I want out of life right now is to get back to South Africa. I don't know why I came to London in the first place.
One more week here, and I'll explode.
Funny you should talk about exploding, because
explosives could very well be a part of this job.
What does that mean?
It's also in Africa.
You must be joking. Are you serious?
£30,000. How's that for serious?
Right, Josh.
Sir.
Come in.
Take clearly. Your name, age, previous military experience, and rank.
Donaldson, sir. Born 1932. 12 years with the Paris, 3 tours with you. The rank of sergeant, sir.
Welcome back, Josh. How have the years been treating you?
Not so good, sir. I'm a plumber now. It's not my line, sir.
You married?
Yes, sir.
Your wife know you're here?
No, sir. She did. She'd do her nuts, sir. If I'm accepted, sir, I'll leave her a note. Sir, you won't regret it. I'm as good a man now as I was at 20, sir.
Why do you want to come with us?
It's the job I do best, sir. I love it.
Blake, Jesse, Colonel Faulkner, sir. Age, within the acceptable range. Experience, you name it, I've had it. Financial status, wiped out. Cannot afford a haircut, sir.
Jesse, I'm glad you got my wire.
So am I, sir. It was my breakfast.
How do you feel about working in Africa?
I don't care where it is, sir, except Switzerland. Neatness scares the shit out of me. And since I see Mr. Jenders sitting over there, I know you're not going up against any sweet and kindly group.
Thank you, Jesse.
Yes, sir. So I'm ready and available and hungry.
You're hired.
Kennel, you've made my day. Would it be possible for you to advance me £20?
Man, that's hungry.
I have this lady barber who charges by the inch, sir.
McTaggart, age 42, sir. 12 years in the Black Watch, rank of sergeant. Undefeated regimental middleweight champion, 6 years running, sir.
What year were you born?
1930,
Come on, I'll jock, you know better than that.
Yes, sir.
How old are you? No rubbish.
47, sir.
You look as if you could do with some exercise.
It will take 4 weeks to change out the fighting weight, sir.
You've been hit a few times.
Yes, sir. A lot of the hitters are still hearing bells, sir. I just like to fight, with weapons or without.
Whitty, Arthur, sir, age 43, medical orderly.
You don't have to go over your qualifications. How are you, Whitty?
Fine, sir.
You look fit?
Thank you, sir. I put a lot into cramping up hospital beds, patients flying around the wards, that sort of thing. Keeps me in shape, sir.
Why do you want to fight with us again?
Colonel Faulkner, 2 years of sorting gallstones at St. Vincent's Hospital is hardening my heart and softening the more important parts. I want to reverse the process.
It could be a bloody one.
Aren't they all? I like to keep busy, sir.
All right, you've got the job.
Thank you, sir. Do I have time to get a divorce?
36 hours.
Oh, lovely, sir. I can't wait to see his face.
Sometimes these things just can't be helped. Anyway, you'll be with the headmaster's family. It'll be nice.
No, it won't. I want to be with you.
You know I want to be with you too.
Then don't go. Please. It's only business.
I have to go.
I don't even know where, what it's about, or anything.
Well, one day I'll tell you. That's a promise. Let's sit down here. That's for fun. Look. I raided Hamley's. It's called Christmas Whenever You Want It.
I don't really want them now.
I understand. I'll give them to the headmaster. He'll give them to you at Christmas.
My mother was here last week with some French man. One of the older boys, she looked like a whore. I didn't know what that was, so I laughed. And then someone told me.
Now listen. You listen to me now. You don't pay any attention to what they say. But you know, and I know. She's the kindest and finest woman there is. And I want you to remember that. Emil?
I have to go back to the game.
I love you.
I love you too.
Big fucking surprise. And those of you who do can expect an infinitely more horrible time than they care to remember. Any man here steps out of line and I will kill him stone dead. It will not worry me in the slightest. There are no Queen's regulations here. So when I say jump, you ask how high? I'll make myself clear. Order here, do I make myself clear? Right. Under command, right and left turn! A and B squads will turn to the right, C and D squads turn to the left! Squads! Right and left!
Right. Let's start for our first heart attack, shall we?
On the command, double march! You will double in a clockwise and an anti-clockwise direction within the confines of the parade ground!
20 paces at the double! 20 paces at the sprint, then fall flat on your bellies! Get up and do it again until I tell you to halt! At the double!
Double! March!
Do I make myself understood? Get up.
I can't, sir.
On your feet, you fucking abortion!
I tried, sir. I'm dead.
Next time you're rolling, get out of my sight there! Come on, move it! Move it, you bloody bastards!
If anybody tries to convince me that I'm still alive, I could hardly believe it.
I was just as much of a wreck as anyone.
All right, gentlemen, let's get down to business. There's one problem to be solved. The sentries at the backs.
I'm going
to lead up. You too. One sentry there, one there, one there. 100 yards of clear killing ground.
And we can't afford to make one sound. They have to be killed instantly and silently.
And there's no cover for 100 yards.
No.
I'd use a crossbow.
Did you think you're out, William Tell?
The one I have in mind will kill at 300 yards. And at 120 yards, the quoll goes straight through a man.
Where does one find such a thing?
Somebody I know in Durban. I'll use hardwood quarrels with files of cyanide attached. The quarrel will shatter inside the man, and if that doesn't kill him instantly, the cyanide will take effect in less than a second, so there is no sign. However, you get me that bow, and I'll do the sentries.
All right, you have it.
Is there anything else for me, sir?
No.
Good night, then.
Peter, is something wrong?
In South Africa, we call the blacks Kaffirs, like you calling them niggers. I don't particularly like them, but I don't like killing them.
I'm sure you've hunted black terrorists in your own country.
Well, those were terrorists, and they were hunting me.
General Ndofa's army kill more innocent people in one day than your terrorists will in 1 year.
Maybe, but that is in Ndofa's country, not in mine.
Our mission is to save the life of Julius Limbani and get him out of here. He is a rather special man.
I'm no good in politics. I don't know Limbani or the people who back him or what for. I only know that I don't like killing people I have nothing to do with.
Then what the hell are you doing here, Peter?
Why, you know that. It is my ticket home. My money to buy a farm. Nothing else. So I'll be killing for me, and I'll live with that later. And you'll be killing to impose your own personal ideas on the future of mankind on others, whether you're right or wrong. I wonder how we stack up against each other morally. Now, is that all, sir?
Morals amongst mercenaries.
Who thought we'd ever see the day? We have to watch him. We can't afford any risks. He's not with us, he's dead.
I know from your record you're all perfect. Don't forget to bend your knees when you hit, take the shock out of it, and roll over. Esposito, what the fuck are you waiting for? Push! Go! Next man, move it. You've got one parachute drop to make, and it better be perfect, or you get left where you fall. Go! Very good. Go!
That was ludicrous, sir. You are jumping from an aeroplane, not a whorehouse window. Do it again.
Sir.
Six,
Get out of the car.
I've got an urgent message to Colonel Falkner.
Get it.
Come in. Gentlemen, sit down. We're going in tomorrow night.
You're kidding, sir.
Tomorrow's Christmas.
We'll celebrate on the 26th.
What the hell happened, sir? They guaranteed a 7 days' notice.
According to this message, some crazy old lady relative of Mbani's had a vision that he'd risen from the dead and it spread through the tribe like the mumps. It's made Nadofa very nervous. He wants to get this thing over fast. And Mbani's being delivered tomorrow night. We'll be there 4 hours later.
That's splendid. Home early. It's the best news I had since I threw up my lunch.
Well, be prepared for our view now. Instead of taking a small bodyguard, Nadofa's taking the Simbas with him. That's his own regiment. And they're very good, as we know.
We'll hardly come across them anyway, so we'll have Mbani out before they get close.
If all goes well. All right, gentlemen, out of business. Rafer?
Sir.
See that the men make their wills. Sean, arrange transportation for the men to go into town. They can kiss their money goodbye if they're not back by 0400.
Drunk, laid, and parlayed.
Well, they deserve it. That's all. Sandy. Ah, sit down. I just wanted to have this private moment with you, old friend. Thank you. You're the best of the best. You've earned your money 5 times over.
I appreciate that, sir, but I'm not quite sure what it means.
It means that I'd like you and your wife to spend that money in good health.
You're trying to tell me I'm not coming along?
Yes.
Sir, with respect, you can stick the money up your ass as to why I can't have you, sir.
Sandy.
I love what I do. Believe it or not, Colonel, I also love those grubby, thick-headed men I trained. You most of all. And I expect to be with them and with you because I'm needed. And if you want to see a real revolution, try and stop me. Stop!
What about that? Who are you leaving your money to, Queenie?
If it's any of your business, to the dearest, kindest proctologist in the whole wide world.
What's that?
Bum doctor to you. Shabby cheeks.
No, thanks, dear. You enjoy yourself.
I've been waiting up for you with bandages and penicillin. Have your bones ready.
Alan, I want you to do something for me. If I buy it, I'd like you to see that my son is all right.
Me?
Yes. I mean, you hooked me into this thing.
Don't you have any decent friends?
Well, I've just made you his godfather.
Look, if his mother doesn't take care of him, I want you to take him away from her.
That's the most insane. You've got an IQ of about 2. When I'm not employed killing perfect strangers, I'm an out of work drunk.
Then a little responsibility would be good. I want your hand on it.
You're not going to die, friend.
I know it. You know it.
I'll ask.
President Limbani.
Yes, sir.
He could need these.
About 3 minutes to exit. They're depressurizing now. Red light on.
Right.
You can lift me, Sergeant Major.
On your feet!
Let's transfer to the cavalry's out of position, Sergeant Major.
Check equipment.
Check equipment!
right where you are. Don't move. No sudden noise. We'd like those keys, you see. So whoever has them, just hand them over.
Mr. Cedar, search his telephone.
Dracula.
Pills from London for your heart. So you just relax, love. Yeah. Drink this. Come on. There you go.
Okay. I'll leave, Mr. Faulkner. That's the master. Peter, he's your responsibility. From now on, he never leaves your sight.
That's fine. All right, let's go. Mr. Peter.
Well then, Kaffer, on your feet.
Here we go, love. That's fine.
All right.
Excellent.
Mrs. Rushton, put Charlie 1 into effect immediately. That's right, immediately. What's so surprising about that?
Well, route it through any embassies you need. That's your job. Do it. Might be a little bit tight. Sounds like a finger up a tin man's backside, doesn't it?
Wild Goose, this is Iron Man, meeting you think for.
Oh, God bless us each and everyone. Iron Man, goose yourself in here. We're waiting. Over.
Well, Adam, we're just 12 minutes behind schedule.
Make you feel good?
Well, if Limbani's heart holds out, I'll feel bloody marvelous.
I hear a plane, sir.
Iron Man, we hear your engines. Sounds like you're southeast of us.
Loaded on and ready to roll now.
Stop.
And find all the spare ammunition and weapons you can. Stop!
I thought we had this in the bag. There's a man called Matheson who has a lot to answer for.
Sir Edward Matheson?
Yes.
He's Charlie One?
Yes, Sir Edward Matheson. He's the money.
What happened?
I'm guessing he made a new deal with Endophis. He doesn't need anybody anymore.
He could have done that yesterday, couldn't he? An aborted mission there.
Yeah, this way he saves himself $500,000, the rest of our pay. Alan, I wouldn't mind meeting this gentleman one day.
Pray for my friend. One day he will. All right, Raven, how do we get out of here?
Where do we go? Within the hour, we're going to have the whole of Endophis' bloody army down us like a ton of bricks.
What do you suggest we do? Surrender?
I'd rather have Witty treat my hemorrhoids.
Raven, we've got 10 minutes. You're the plan.
Alan, I've got something to say to you. I'll give it to you emotionally first, and then rationally if I have to. This man, Madison? Well, he gave us the royal screwing of all time. Now, my first instinct is to give it back to him, the dealer.
Yes, me too, but that's for some other time.
We came to get Lombardi. We've got him. I said we used him. We showed him to his tribesmen. They think he's been reincarnated. They're about ready for a civil war anyway. Maybe we can stop it. God knows. Maybe we can even win it.
Hot. Right there. Now, listen to me, Rafer. I've got 50 good men down there, and their lives are my responsibility. I'm not on any bloody crusade. I don't want to do battle with you, Rafer. At least not now. So just get on with it and get us out of here.
Then I'll give it to you rationally. The North is out of the question.
Why? What have we got hold of the ferry to Burundi?
I wouldn't cross that lake and destroy it. Endophis planes would pick us up like ducks. They wouldn't let us into Burundi anyway. No wonder. Zambia's too far, and east, 600 miles of jungle, totally impossible.
Well, it still leaves the south.
Exactly. South. Libibani country. Now I know it well. There's a dry river there, an old stone bridge. If we cross that bridge, we're on our way to Kalima.
What's in Kalima?
Libibani was born there. I think I can work out.
Rafer.
For God's sake, it's the only chance we have of accomplishing something from this whole fucking mess!
50 men in the Valley of the Shadow, and he wants to take over an entire country.
Well, we've got no bloody place to run to! So why not stand and fight? And for a cause. For two causes. One, Limbani. He's the best there is. Words from your own lips. And two, Madison.
You know, Rafer, sometimes it's almost a pleasure knowing you.
All right. Let's do it.
Let's do it.
That would help me when I have some maniacs.
Have a good trip. Goodbye.
Good. Call me back when you get confirmation.
Well, here's to General Indova. They're a difficult bastard to negotiate with, but I'm pleased with the deal. Cheers, General.
Let's hope Indova continues to honor it.
Oh, he will. He's got a brand new financing, and we've got the mines. We're back in the copper business.
Whitty! keep going for about another hour. Then we hold up somewhere for a while. How many men have we left, Sandy?
Carry the colonel's group. 32, including 6 walking wounded, sir.
Ah, that's a hell of a formidable unit.
Not unlike to be up against it, sir.
Until noon, and then we'll rest. I'll take it.
Come on.
All right. I'll take point.
Let me carry him, Lieutenant.
No way. Just hang on, Capper. I bleed red like you, white man. Don't call me Capper.
Take that hand off my face.
Capper. Where do you come from? Rhodesia?
South Africa.
South Africa. I met Jan Smuts a long time ago. He was a good man.
I don't get to meet prime ministers. Well, now shut up!
Yes, sir.
What do you want?
Just to talk.
Talk? Why, no wonder you're a politician.
I haven't had anyone to talk to for over 2 years. Just prison guard. I entertain myself by trying to taunt them into killing me.
Now you're trying the same on me. Christ, go to sleep, man.
Man, that's an improvement over Kefa. What did you do in South Africa?
I fought the black troublemakers.
Who were they fighting, and why?
You are asking me whether I understand the politics of my own country. The answer is no, all right?
Well, at least you had an equal opportunity to neglect your education. What would you like to do there?
I want a place of my own. That's all saving your life means to me. The chance to work my own land as a free man in a country I love.
That's good enough. Only one thing to remember about Africa. Today, freedom is only a word for a new oppressor. Black or white, north or south. If you want to live here, you better think about tomorrow.
That's the name of
it. Picturesque.
Sandy.
Sir?
Post guards. Send a patrol into the village.
Sir. Dust them off.
Sir.
Ride me through the bush like a bloody mule and laugh at me. You can bloody well crawl. Do we whites have carried you people on our backs ever since we came to this country?
It's the other way around, isn't it?
Is it? You need me to save your miserable black life right now, don't you?
I do. And then you may need me to save yours. We need each other, white men. That's the way it should be. We've got the whole world using us now, setting group against group, destroying Africa. Our new freedom is just another label for their brand of slavery. And the final bloodbath is coming. First between black and white, and then between black and black when you whites have left Africa for good.
Man, we have built your countries, and now you are kicking us out of almost all of them. You are living on foreign aid, robbing your own people blind. You are crying about outside oppression while you are killing each other in great big bleeding batches. Now, once you have something better to offer, then you come talk to us in the White South.
We both have something better to offer. Listen to me, because the White South is next unless you land.
Oh, bullshit. We whites were born here. We are just as African as you are, and don't make a mistake. We are going to stay.
I'm glad to hear that. Then you'd better join us and help us sort out our future.
Join you?
We've got to learn to care for each other, or there'll be nothing left of our Africa but a band or battlefield.
You have a point there, but do you have an answer?
I have the will to look forward. We have to forgive you for the past, and you have to forgive us for the present. If we have no future together, white men, we have no future. That's what I believe in. And that's what I'm willing to die for.
You're beginning to sound good to me. Maybe we need you.
Maybe you're just the man.
All right. Let's get moving.
Maybe I'm a bloody fool. I'm going to take you there just to find out if you are lying.
Just hang on tight. Look.
You and your guns. I am. We need your help, Father. To go and kill more of your brothers.
I hope not. They haven't changed a bit, but it's nice to see you.
I despise the sight of you. I want you out of my village.
Well, let's talk about it up here, shall we?
You big bastards. What a bloody shame we can't be friends.
Thank you.
you go fast.
Oh, no. After I found you. Don't die. Please don't die.
You can leave him now, Mr. President. He's dead.
Yes.
I think so.
As you might say, Mr. Faulkner, I'm just hanging on. Tell me if I'm wrong. You would like my people to rise up and fight.
I'd like your country to be yours, sir.
Yes, so would I. But I think spears against machine guns was not the plan.
If we started it, we might have something to back us up. It's happened before. Copper can be a powerful persuader, sir.
I've been through all this with him. God knows you know how much I love to do it, but we haven't got a chance.
I bet you say that before.
I'm saying it now. These people spawned a whole battalion of settlers about an hour ago. There's more following.
What the devil are we doing here?
Well, we're trying to save a good man for a better day.
With 30 men, what are we supposed to do, walk out of Africa?
Probably to try running. Alan, please. The simple fact is, they've got nothing to fight with.
We have nowhere to run.
God in heaven is true. I didn't truly believe the rumor.
We're a little pressed for time, Father.
Yeah, Faulkner.
That's right.
Don't call me your father, you murdering pig.
I haven't got time to discuss my finer qualities with you now. Just get those elders in here to have a look at it.
Chief, we'll leave behind. You seem a little born on this one, yeah.
I would like to speak with my people alone.
Hey. My belief you're trying to start a civil war here, Faulkner. You'll be responsible for slaughter and starvation of the likes of which you've never imagined. You'll be up to your eyes in blood. And you'll die, Faulkner. All of you. And all of us. So aim against you. And God's against you. And if you'll excuse the blasphemy, we're tough sons of bitches, the both of us.
So sort of talk to get back to the Vatican, Father.
You shut your mouth! Oh, I turn these people against you! In spite of them, Barney! I crush you from every hit! All right, that's enough. The decision's being made in there.
All right, I offer you a bargain, Faulkner. About 3 miles from here, through the bush, there's a mine airstrip with an old Dakota sitting on it right now.
What did you say? What?
A Dakota? It's all right. I've flown it. And there's nothing between it and us but a deserted village. I lead you there myself. You've still got time to get him back out of here and leave us in peace.
Well, Mr. President?
If they stand and fight now, they will die. And they know it. But they were willing. I can't do that, Mr. Faulkner. I can't. You understand? I told them to bear their pain and wait to be ready for the body's return. And they agreed, without understanding why.
All right, sir. You rest here. We're going to get you out. Billy, you got your bargain.
Praise God.
Raise Limbani. Now show us where that airplane is. Sean, take 4 men and check it out, then let me know. We'll be following.
All right, Ellen.
Sandy!
Sir!
Get the men out and ready to move. We can't take the vehicles.
Sir! Right to me, all of you! Come on, the devil!
Made the right decision, Alan.
Limbani made it, I didn't.
Well, he can't help his country from here. Now the question is, what will we do with him once we get him out?
Who knows? He may be backing elsewhere, another contract.
You never quit, do you?
If I did, I wouldn't have a future, would I? Also, don't laugh, but that
That man there, he...
I know. He got you, right?
Yes.
Hey, yeah, boys. There she is, over there. Good afternoon. Now, are you going to fly this thing, or am I?
Yes. They could be anywhere. You have to go ahead. Great. You're the rear guard. Take three men. Keep close to us. Jesse, take point and go like hell. Sandy, take care of Mrs. McBarney.
Yes, sir.
Sandy, when there's no one around, you can call me out.
Yes, sir. Of course, sir.
John, I think they spotted us. Don't pull back.
And don't start up until you get there. I want it quiet. Out.
Father, I think you should get on your ass and locate the premises.
You're likely to get your signal shut off.
I do that. Good luck to you, brothers, murderers.
Well, that's one of the most moving benedictions I ever heard.
A Merry Christmas to your father.
What's left of it?
Try and get this wreck off the ground in the dark. So we try and find them, sir, and lead them in.
We don't know where they're coming from.
Derek, you stay with me, sir.
John, take the thing and set it up this end of the bed.
Sir, hey, get out! Come on, get the biggest out of here. Come on, move!
We're dead.
Mr. Zito, you're not dead until I tell you you're dead, understand?
Yes, sir.
Wait. 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 Wait.
Thank you.
money on the thing first. The others follow and cover. Yes, sir. We'll have to wait for Sandy and his group if they get through. They've got Josh set us up on the edge of the airstrip. Move.
plateau.
South. Rhodesia.
That's 800 miles. I don't know where the fuel.
We better have it. There's no other place to go. Sean. I killed Rafe. Simmons would have cut him up into small pieces.
And I'm going to see how the men are.
There are 13 of us left alive.
Tell them to jettison everything that's not nailed down. Everything, do it now.
Sir, Mr. Nibani's getting worse.
It was a very good try, Mr. Forrest.
It's not over. Just hang on, sir. Don't give up now.
Colonel, about Mr. Jandis. There was nothing else to do.
What was it for, sir?
I know. All right. We have to jettison everything on board. Think to tell Joff. See to the dust.
Yes, sir. Gennaro, get his legs.
How's the fuel?
Bad. We're on auxiliary tanks. Salisbury Control, 9 at Quebec. November X-ray Alpha on 6603. Do you read? Over.
Going to Quebec, November X-ray Alpha. This is Salisbury. Meeting you straight through. Go ahead. Over.
We are a mercenary unit departing Colima. 7 wounded on board. Urgently request permission to land. Karima.
Excuse. Keep on talking.
X-ray Alpha. Stand by.
Mr. Limbani. Mr. Limbani. Sir, we're going to need positive proof that you're on board.
It is done.
It is.
Member X-ray Alpha, this is 4-3 control.
Alan?
Reading you, strength 4.
Permission to land denied. Do not cross our borders under any circumstances.
Oh, for Christ's sake, man, we've wounded on board. We can sort it out later. Over.
I repeat, do not attempt to cross our borders. Our air force is alerted.
Give me that thing.
Our air force is alerted. We'll be forced to shoot you down.
Salisbury, X-ray Alpha. Now you listen. We have Julius Limbani aboard and he's alive. Now, write this down and get him to the highest official you can find.
Stop on fuel change.
Mr. Limbani says there was a secret meeting in July of 1960 on the now Zambia Zaire border concerning federal intervention in the Congo crisis. Present at the meeting were the following. Mr. Julius Limbani himself.
Anything else this evening, sir? Mm-hmm. Oh, no, thank you. Good night.
Yes, what is it, Andrew?
There will be something more tonight, Sir Edward. Go ahead and make a move. That will be Mayton, too. I'd like to see you get yourself out of that. But that's for some other time.
There are 6 servants in the house.
I thought at least 10. How do you make do?
What do you want, Faulkner?
You're a very bad conversationalist.
Oh, please forgive me. I've had a rather tiresome evening.
I heard. I was in the drawing room.
I know you're dying for me to ask. How did you get in here?
I took a crash course in how to trip burglar alarm wires. You're not very safe yet. And I'm sure you're dying to know how I got out of Rhodesia and back into England.
Oh, I am indeed.
Well, if I went into details, we'd be here all night. Let's just say it wasn't easy.
No, I'm sure it wasn't. You are a remarkable man, Faulkner. I have contracts out on you everywhere.
When I have time, I'm going to grow a mustache and buy myself a pair of dark glasses. In the meantime, I have my own contract to worry about.
On me?
That's why I'm here.
Perhaps we could make an arrangement.
Yes, we can. You owe me a great deal of money. Also, there are 11 other men still living. I haven't even counted the widows and orphans yet. Let's have a look what's in your safe. After you. And very quietly. I turned off the alarm in the frame. Open it. All the money in the case.
I see you came prepared.
Yes, yes. Dollars, very good. My heavens, $1,000 bills. I'd wager the US Treasury wonders where all that went to. Now tell me about the arrangement.
There's $500,000 there. About half of what I owe you. Now, I'll lift all the contracts on you and pay you the other half in cash wherever you choose.
And I trust you.
You do.
And naturally, I don't kill you.
Correct.
No, I had a speech prepared for you. I've been rehearsing it for 3 months. It was pretty good, as a matter of fact. All about the betrayals and dead friends. Kind of a passionate requiem. And naturally, what a filthy, cold-blooded monster you are, etc., etc. The part was very eloquent. It even went into the philosophical implications of the relationships between the mercenary and his employer. You would have been impressed. But right now, face to face with you, I don't really want to go through all that. You see, I don't mind taking money from you. But having you offer me money for your life with all those bodies littering Africa is actually degrading. So I turned down your arrangements.
I see. Well, I suppose you'd better kill me.
You're a remarkable man, too, Sir Edwin. So I suppose I better have.
Wait a minute.
To ask how it went?
No.
That's all. Throw the ball back at me.
Let's talk about your father.
Sad are the eyes, yet no tears. The flood of the wild geese brings a new home. Rescue from all this, old friends, and those who live out. Watch out!